So color is a psychological phenomenon, all right? You know, in fact, let me go back to something here. If I turn on a red light and a green light and I blend them together, what color will I see?
Yellow?
Yellow, right. So, why? When I tell people this at Georgia Tech, some of them tell me, oh, well, you know, red is here in the spectrum and green is here in the spectrum, and when you turn on both of them, you get the average spectrum. No. The light doesn't know anything about averaging. So here is a green light, and here is a red light. What happens is this light over here in the green triggers the green cones a little bit more than the red cones. And the red light makes the red cones go a little bit more than the green cones. Okay, so let's pretend for a moment they were sort of balanced. So in other words, if I had a yellow light, which makes both of the cones go about the same amount, your system can't tell the difference between a green light and a red light turned on versus a yellow light. Forget this little blue stuff here for now, all right? So the reason that red plus green make yellow with light has nothing to do with physics and everything to do with how your retina is put together, right? The red and green cones go on at the same time. So color is psychological. That is, you can think of color as represented as some combination, linear combination otherwise, of red, green, and blue. And it's related to cones, not to physics. By the way, almost all of us have the same cones, but there are some people who don't. Right? So the sky might not really look blue to them, although actually to them it looks blue, but it's actually not blue because they actually can't see blue. So these people are referred to as colorblind. All right? A bunch of people are missing one type of cone. Almost all of them, by the way, are men. Some reasonable percentage of men are colorblind. Some tiny, tiny percentage of women are colorblind. So it's kind of funny. Back when I was a grad student in psychology class, people have to sometimes do a So I was the TA, people would have to do an experiment and write it up and hand it in. And you could tell every now and then when somebody, shall we say, ran out of time to actually do a real experiment, because they'd say they worked with 20 colorblind patients, 10 men, 10 women. For them to find 10 colorblind women, they probably would have sampled more than Massachusetts. So there are very few colorblind women.